Sports. It's in the game.
This test is all about tyre management. Try to control the slick through each corner and take extra care putting the power down at the apex. job indeed. You got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. Session has drawn to a close, so let's review our top three. Princess Pitstop, Leclerc and Lewis Hamilton. And that's it. Practice is officially over. Until next time, goodbye. done. That was a fantastic drive.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Princess Pitstop, Hamilton and George Russell. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. The Spanish Grand Prix has been a permanent fixture on the Formula One calendar for over 30 years now, and for good reason. Do you remember Michael Schumacher's absolute dominance here in that rain-soaked Grand Prix in 1996? That day, he took his first ever victory for Ferrari, and we've had many more iconic moments since. It's a sellout crowd of 140,000 here today as we await lights out for the 730-meter sprint down into Turn 1. This is a 2.9-mile racetrack. Overtaking is challenging through the 16 corners, but there's still a lot of high-speed excitement to be found, including the flat-out Turn 3 and the terrifying blind right of Turn 9. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Princess Pitstop lines up on pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Russell, Sainz, Charles Leclerc, and Verstappen, Norris, Michael Schumacher, Perez, and Daniel Ricciardo, Fernando Alonso, Gasly, Valtteri Bottas, and Ocon, Vettel, Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher, and Kevin Magnussen, Albon, Stroll, Latifi, and Guan Yu Zhou. Now it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track. And a warm welcome to Natalie Pinkham, who's beside me in the commentary box today. Let's talk about Princess Pitstop. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, they've been avoiding mistakes and have had solid pace, so it's been a good season so far. But whether they can keep that up long term remains to be seen.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. By 17.3 seconds.
Faces up and down the pit wall after that one, but not here. They've secured a phenomenal victory. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. See how the driver standings have changed. Princess Pitstop increases their championship lead. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Princess Pitstop. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as shown a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend for them as they fight their way towards the top. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One, so be sure to join us for the next one.
Morning, boss. This week's income from the sponsors has cleared, and we're making good profit against our running costs. I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.
We're going to be logging some extra data during this session. Nothing you need to worry about, but as we have some new parts on the car, we'll just confirm they're performing to spec.
As many corner gates as quickly and precisely as possible. Remember to activate your DRS in the DRS zone as well.
approaching the DRS zone. Watch your MFD for the activation point. Good work. You seem to have a solid handle on the lap. Let's try and perfect each turn. Remember that chaining good corners together will give you a consistency bonus. We've only got 2 laps of fuel left. Calculate a good race strategy. far, we're getting great data. Stay focused. Exactly what we asked for. Keep it up. So far, we're getting great data. Stay focused. Exactly what we asked for. Keep it up. We'll be right back. Lovely, and that was a really good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. Just give it everything. In this test, we just want to make sure we can lap close to our rival's pace. Give it everything. In this test, we just want to make sure we can lap close to our rival's pace. job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers.
Remind ourselves of our top three, who are Princess Pitstop, Hamilton and Charles Leclerc. And if today's practice is anything to go by, we're in for an exceptional weekend of Formula One. And with the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Princess Pitstop, Hamilton and George Russell. What an incredible practice session that was. But the fun doesn't stop here though. Join us again as the rest of the weekend unfolds.
Thank you.
excellent lap. We're very pleased with that.
With qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three: Princess Pitstop, Hamilton, and Charles Leclerc. With qualifying complete, all that remains now is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. Thank you.
Thank you.
Formula One returns to Monte Carlo once again today, home to the world-famous Monte Carlo Casino that first opened in 1863. And of course, a certain road race first held in 1929. There's no greater an occasion, no more valuable a win than the Monaco Grand Prix. The prestigious Circuit de Monaco then is not all that dissimilar today to the layout that made its debut almost a century ago. It's 2 miles and 19 corners through the streets of Monte Carlo. And although the average lap speed of around 93 miles per hour is the lowest of the season, the tiny margins for error make it the natural habitat of the safety car. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Princess Pitstop lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Leclerc, Verstappen, George Russell, and Sainz. Michael Schumacher, Norris, Perez, and Fernando Alonso. Ricciardo, Gasly, Guan Yu Zhou, and Albon. Ocon, Mick Schumacher, Valtteri Bottas, and Sebastian Vettel. Tsunoda, Magnussen, Stroll, and Nicholas Latifi. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Now I wonder, Anthony Davidson, might we be in for some early pit stops today from the midfield teams, trying to put a bit of pressure on or disrupt things for the leaders?
If you're in the middle of the pack, you know, you got your own race to run, I don't think they're going to be thinking about causing trouble up front. However, closer to the head of the pack, don't be surprised to see some split strategies. If you're running second and third, for example, bringing one car in for an undercut while leaving the other one out there longer can put a lot of pressure on the leader and maybe force them into an error.
Okay, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. Start to see a loss of power. DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Charges on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. Final lap of the race. Your 8th consecutive win in a row, that is just amazing. Congratulations.
And with that, we wrap up yet another incredible Grand Prix weekend. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way onto the podium now. After this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Princess Pitstop increases their championship lead. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to Princess Pitstop. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.
Oh.
They told you about the new parts that have come in from the factory, right? Well, they're all fitted and good to go. I hope they do the trick. Your goal is to get through as many corner gates as quickly and precisely as possible. Best of luck out there. Okay, DRS zone coming up. Get ready to open it. 15 is on your MFD. Understanding of this circuit. Thank you. pretty much nailed this circuit. This is a really strong foundation to build from over the course of the weekend. Indeed, you got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. that's looking good. Now let's try for purple. You get a bonus for consistency if you can chain good corners together. quali sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat.
Has drawn to a close, so let's review our top three. Princess Pitstop, Norris, and Carlos Sainz. And if today's practice is anything to go by, we're in for an exceptional weekend of Formula One.
Good work. You seem to have a solid handle on the lap. Let's try and perfect each turn. Remember that chaining good corners together will give you a consistency bonus. Program. Decent data, although far from optimal, and it could still be worth running it again. Okay, give us some good, consistent laps, please. We're looking for good data that we can work into a race strategy. We're getting great data. Stay focused. Keep it up. job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused. Exactly what we asked for. Keep it up. And a job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers.
Remind ourselves of our top three, who are Princess Pitstop, Sainz, and George Russell. What an incredible practice session that was, but the fun doesn't stop here though. Join us again as the rest of the weekend unfolds.